So today's session we are going to discuss about the bend rule. So bend rule explains the energy of hybrid orbitals formed during hybridization will not be same if the molecule is heteroleptic or if it contains lone pairs with trigonal bipyramidal or square pyramidal or pentagonal bipyramidal geometry. So as we all of you know that the hybridization, during hybridization, the hybrid orbitals will be having usually similar energy, but there are some exceptions where you will observe two different energy hybrid orbitals in the hybridization. So that was explained by bend rule. Particularly, bend was explained the hybridization, that is sp3d trigonal bipyramidal geometry, sp3d hybridization. He found two different hybrid orbitals. That was the combination of sp2 and as well as pz square. Here you can see the sp3d is having two different sets of energetic hybrid orbitals, that are sp2 and as well as pz square hybrid orbitals. Whereas here if you observe the sp2 hybrid orbitals, so for example in the sp3d hybridization will be found, that is trigonal bipyramidal geometry. Here you can see the structure. In this it is having two different sets of hybrid orbitals, that is sp2 which is contributing this trigonal planar geometry, and pz square which is actually contributing this straight line, that is a linear. So in this case the sp2 hybridization is actually contributing 33% of s character. So how to calculate s character in the hybridization? So s character we can be calculated by using the formula, that is cos theta equals to s upon s minus 1. So in the sp2 hybridization, here if you observe trigonal planar, the angle between any atom equals to 120. So cos 120 if you substitute, so here which is equals to minus of, so if you solve this s value you will get as 1/3, which is equals to 33.3%. That means the sp2 hybrid orbitals is usually having 33.3% of s character, and the dz square, that is pz dz square hybrid orbitals has 0 s character. Why? Because the pz dz square orbital, the bond angle between the adjacent atoms is equals to 90 degrees, so cos 90 is 0, which further makes equals s equals to 0%. So he found that which is having a two different bond angles, and which is having, one is having 33%, another is having 0% bond angle. So here what is happening, if percentage of s character of any bond increases, so gradually what is happening, the percentage of s character increases gradually, it will also increases the makes bond stronger and as well as shorter. So that is the reason you can observe in the trigonal planar the bond is little shorter than this straight line. Here you can observe the PCL bond length is 202, which is little shorter than 214, right? Why? Because the percentage of s character increases gradually, which is making the bond stronger and as well as shorter due to the high electronegative character of this bond and also the bulkiness of s orbital. And later on, if the percentage of p character increases, what will happen? If the percentage of p character increases, gradually the bond longevity and as well as thinness increases. So here if you observe, in the case of pz dz square hybrid orbitals, the percentage of p character is greater, it is equals to 50%. So that is why, so the bond longevity and as well as thinness also increases, that is it is little lengthier than this bond. That's why the PCL bond is shorter and PF bond is little longer. So from all these, the bend has proposed a rule, that is more electronegative substituents always prefer hybrid orbitals are having less s character. That means here you can observe where you are observing less s character, in the trigonal planar or in the straight line. In the straight linear line you will observe the less s character because this is contributing by pz dz square hybrid orbitals. So the bend rule is what? More electronegative substituents always prefers hybrid orbitals which are having less s character, and more electropositive substituents always prefer hybrid orbitals are having more s character. So that is the reason The fluorine is actually trying to occupy the axial position because it is more electronegative, so less s character, and chlorine is always trying to occupy the trigonal planar position, so that is which is having a greater s character. So by using this bent rule, it is having a four very important applications. So one by one we will see. The first important application is the bent rule also explains the structure of mixed trigonal bipyramidal geometries. Mixed indicates it is not made with a single element. It is made up with a mix. Mix means it is having a chlorofluoride, particularly the chlorofluorides of alkyl phosphorus fluorides or else. And also it explains the different electronegative substituents occupying at axial position. And also finally, the bent rule was proposed that always in the trigonal bipyramidal geometry, the more electronegative substituent is occupying axial position and less electronegative substituent is occupying equatorial position. So if you observe one by one example, the first example is SF4. In the SF4, the lone pair and fluorine. Here fluorine is more electronegative, that is why it is occupying axial. Lone pair is less electronegative, which is occupying equatorial. Next, ClF3. In the ClF3, the fluorine is more electronegative, that is why it is occupying axial. Lone pairs are less electronegative, that is why it is occupying equatorial. Next, xenon O2F2. In this case, the oxygen is more electronegative or fluorine. Fluorine is more electronegative, that is why it is going to occupy axial. Why? Because in axial there is less s character. And oxygen is going to occupy at equatorial position. Next, the PF2Cl3, same, fluorine is more electronegative, which is occupying axial. Fluorine is less electronegative, which is occupying equatorial. The last example is SF2Cl2, where also you can observe fluorine is occupying axial and chlorine is occupying equatorial. So all these structures, trigonal bipyramidal geometric structures, the position of electronegative and electropositive atom can be easily predicted by using this bent rule. Next, the second application of this bent rule is, the bent rule also explains the reason why two different bond angles existing in the same molecule. We all know that the tetrahedral geometry's general bond angle is 109, but in the case of difluoromethane, it is a tetrahedral, but it is having a two different bond angles rather than single bond angle like methane. Why? Because all the four substituents are not equal. So that is the reason here you will observe the bond angle between the FCF, which is always lesser than 109, and the bond angle between HCH, which is always greater than 109. The reason why? Because as the percentage of S character increases, the bond angle also increases. Here the percentage of S character decreases, bond angle decreases. Next, the third application is, the tendency of more electronegative substituent is seek out of the low electronegative PZ, PX, DX square apical position. This is often termed as epicophilicity. That means, we already discussed that more electronegative atom is always preferred to occupying the apical, that is axial position, which is also called it as epicophilicity, which can easily be illustrated by using example, that is oxysulfurans. Oxysulfurans, if you consider, the oxygen is more electronegative, so which is always trying to occupying at axial position. Next, the fourth example, the fourth application of bent rule is, here, this is the exception. If you observe the structure of cyclic bromophosphate esters, here we all know that oxygen is more electronegative than bromine, but rather than oxygen, bromine is occupying axial position. This was the exception. Why? Because the bromine is less electronegative, though it is less electronegative, which is having a diffused orbitals for the poor overlap. That is the reason here bromine is occupying axial position rather than equatorial. And next, the modification of bent rule. The modified bent rule is nothing but here the orbitals are having more space, which is having more s character. That we know, right? So whenever the more s character, more bulkiness, the orbitals will provide more space. That means lone pair always trying to locate at more space. So lone pair always trying to locate at more space. Here you can observe the bond angle between these two fluorines is more greater bond angle. So that's why lone pair is always trying to locate at wherever more space is there only the lone pair will be occupying. Similarly, if you observe the xenon F5 structure, the lone pair is occupying axial rather than equatorial. Why? Because the bond angle between here is 90 degree, which is 72. So here the bond angle is more. So the wherever more space, there only the more chance of locating the lone pair. So that these two are the except these two will be explained on the basis of modified pent rule. So at the final, we will just have a glance on the previous year questions. What type of questions will come for the competitive exam? So there is a question that is how many bond angles are observed for CH2Br2. We all know that this is actually heteroleptic tetrahedral geometry, which is having two different bond angles that just now we have seen. One is actually greater than 109 between bromine C bromine, and another angle is lesser than 109, which is HCH bond angle. The next question, according to Bent rule, for the P block element, the correct combination of geometry around the central atom and the position of more electronegative atom. So the correct combination is always more electronegative atom prefer at axial position, less electronegative atom prefer at equatorial. Why? Because more electronegative prefers at less S character and less electronegative prefers at more S character. So in that way, the questions will come from this topic. So thank you for watching this video.